So, how's your 30-second warm-up? Ready. Hey, you know, part of that 30-second warm-up, you know, like, big part of it could be just testing the resistance of that note against your wind and. Know right where it is when you're going to start. You have water in the key?
No, I accidentally.
What's that?
I accidentally.
Oh. Very good. So, let's hear that first note. Don't worry about even going further, but just with me. I'll give you one, two, three. One, two, three. Okay, good. We'll do it again. Let's do it again. One, two. Okay. Again. No, don't fix the reed. One, two, three. Good. All right, so what are you thinking about to make it more consistent when you do those repeated attacks?
Mostly just trying to get my air right.
Yeah,
yeah. Make sure my tongue's right pretty much before I start.
Prepare the air, huh? And get your tongue right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what about the reed? What about it, huh? I think that the fulcrum thought is important. That if you're high up on the facing of the mouthpiece, you don't know what's going to come out. If you maybe a little nervous and you're up here and right, but if you go too far down, you might get the squawk, but there's miles of real estate between closing it off and squeaking like that. And I really encourage you to get a little further down and then just gauging how much of a prepared airstream is going to make the sound just start. That's very good. You know, share a little secret. I like to start that with the one and one fingering because I like the legato. It's a little lower in pitch and you start really quietly like that. You don't want to be sharp. Would you try that fingering? Yeah, see, I prefer it. It's more even. It's more of the. It's almost like on a string instrument. You're going to play the first note on the E string and then switch to the D. Or you're going to start up with the same kind of quality. Of course, if the instrument's not adjusted at the bridge, not going to work. So just for insurance, I always touch this little key with the second finger to make sure everything's covering. Okay, use that fingering, take a big breath, and let's do the beginning again. Yeah, let's just concentrate on that interval, the B flat to the F sharp, back and forth a few times. Yeah, but slowly. Yeah, can you do it without a bump? Just I don't know if I can. Try to match the volume, the timbre, the intensity of sound. Yeah, without hesitation. Yeah, we learn all these scales and rapid fire technical things, but this is just as technical. It's a physical thing that you have to practice connecting one note to another. And it involves coordination of fingers, coordination of the embouchure, the shape of the voicing, what you're doing with the wind, and just the sound that's going to occur between the two notes. So that's something to practice. Let's do some more of that. Yeah, almost feel, move the fingers together, but almost feel like you're squeezing. So you're really covering the tone holes. Yeah, if you don't move them fingers together, you're going to get a hesitation. If there's one finger that's lazy, if you don't get this maybe this ring is a little high and you're not completely covering it. So, you know, I don't want to give you tendonitis, but for now, really, really squeeze. Okay, so figure out which finger is lazy and move it earlier. To me, it sounds like this second hole is the one that's late, but yeah, now without the glissando. I stopped only after I got one I liked. The last one was better. Okay, that's better. That was good. So there are a lot of elements to that, right? Get a big breath and play the phrase with that kind of legato throughout. Okay, we've got to fix that. Are you?
You're not used to.
Yeah. What did you just do differently?
Not sure exactly. Try to just focus more on the fingers, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Focus more on the fingers. Move them together. What if the fingers are actually closer to the holes? So, you know, you don't have to go that far when you can just go that far. Yeah. Okay, now keep the airstream really relentless. Keep it moving. Fulcrum, get a little further down. Get a big breath. Open up a little more, get further down the reed. Okay, I sent you too far down the rabbit hole there, sorry. So this is a wonderful, wonderful example of learning to play legato despite the registration. If you really have your destinations as the third bar and then the third bar of the second four-bar phrase, to the second part, the fifth bar. Keep the A in the line so you can really continue the B flat in the next bar. Yeah, so it sounds a little waltzy to me. You know, I don't think of this as a da, 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 but more of a sustained. Yeah, we need stronger third beat actually now, and really legato, but not accented on the first beat. Yeah. So you can make exercises out of this. Just practice that interval. Figure out which finger is slow and move it ahead of time. Make sure the air is moving between the notes. And then the same thing with the because you have to coordinate both hands, covering rings and covering and opening a key. So it's, or excuse me, closing a key. Okay, now give me an 8-bar phrase and do everything you can to have it make sense and show the direction of where you're going with the sound. Thank you. I think we should stop there because that was, you really did it that time. It was beautiful. Thank you very much. Very good. Very nice sound. Good. Terrific.